Hi everybody, this particular video is about how to build your data science portfolio and why is it important. You see, so data science has a lot of many different things you take into consideration in parallel. So while you're learning, you will be learning the theoretical part, you'll be learning the implementation part, you'll be learning the mathematics behind it, you'll be learning the latest algorithms out there, the old ones, the new ones, the intermediate ones. All kind of things. So there are the mathematics, the software engineering skills, as well as the statistics, Python or R, usually Python, and a lot of frameworks. If you're working on machine learning, you'll be learning SQLR, you'll be learning stats models, you'll be learning Keras, TensorFlow, PyTorch, either of them or all of them, depending upon your tolerance capacity, better to say. So that is one perspective. Like, okay, preparation of the things which are there in the data science is one thing, is one aspect. But the other aspect is how to put it forward, how to show and demonstrate to the people, like, yeah, so this is the things I gathered and this is what I can deliver. So this video is how to make your understanding deliverable to people so that the world gets to know that you know what you know about data science. So a very short brief video about how you can build your data science portfolio. So see, there are three types of things or the projects. Broadly, I would say there are three types of projects you can make. First is the experimental or core research type project. What is that? So you pick up a Jupyter notebook or you open a Python script, you pick up a data set and you make your own analysis, you make your own model predictions, you make your you build up a project. And that is one aspect. So that is the most usual thing you'll find over GitHub or you'll find over the Kaggle notebooks. Second aspect is the PyPy projects. What those PyPy projects are? Those PyPy projects are a different category of projects. So those are kind of, those depict your software engineering skills. However, those kind of projects are like your packages, better to say packages, and those help you a lot. And that is a different dimension or a different class of projects that helps you in. So that helped me a lot in developing my Python skills, as well as that's a community open source package which is helpful to everybody who wants to use a reusable code. So that is the whole idea of PyPy projects. And lastly is making an application. So you pick up a practical aspect of any data set. Let's say you're working on a animals data set, so you're working on, let's say, dogs data set. So you are identifying the different kinds of the breeds or the different species of dogs, not the species of dogs, basically, yeah, different subclasses of dogs. So if you were to perform it the first way, it would be a simple experimental thing. So you would be like picking up the data set, gathering up all the information, building your analysis, model predicting, developing a summary report, and that's it. But when it comes to making an app, so there's a lot of different perspectives. So there's, you need to take into consideration a lot of things. You need to take into consideration the software engineering skills, as well as the model deployment and modeling things. So that's a different perspective. However, I'll cover all three of them. Coming to the first aspect, this is the most generic aspect. The first one is picking up any general project or any random data set. You pick up a random data set. Let's say I am working on, don't pick too many trivial data sets. To begin with, it's good to pick up a trivial data set. Like, so it's all not expected, like you're a beginner, I am a beginner, and I will be picking up the best of the best data sets. It's absolutely fine to pick up the most trivial data sets and work on them. If you are able to give something valuable, if you are able to understand something from what is being taught to you, is good, is absolutely perfect. So, and the best way, And the best way is like, so you pick up a data set and just put in your understanding, just put in your like, this is a data set and this is my understanding, this is my initial model, this is my initial model workflow or pipeline that I could generate, right? So that is one thing. Now there's always a scope of improvement. So absolutely, there's always a scope of improvement. So you do your initial data analysis or whatever it is, modeling, prediction. And after you're done, you'll get to know like, okay, this is a possible improvement. You read other people's work. You can read other people's work on the same data set. You get to find something, one or two new points. You study about those points. Let's say you have taken up a tabular data set, right? So you're taken up a tabular data set, you do the initial analysis, you do the initial model predicting, you publish it to Kaggle or you publish it to Git, and yeah, so that is your initial level. So that is the version one of your project of the type one, like, yeah, perfect. So then you learn about something new, let's say in a week or in 2 weeks, like, okay, so there's one thing like grid search, there's one thing like K-fold thing, cross-validation thing. Okay, so then you get to know, okay, so K-fold is one thing, then we have hold-out folds, right? So even if K-fold is like you're kind of partially promoting data leakage, so best out of the all the possible combinations is take one part as always, like, as a consider one part as not to be seen, and the rest of the part, whatever it is, however you want to divide or distribute the data set as a cross validation, that is a different topic. I'll come back in one of the future videos. However, the thing which I would like to discuss is like, so yeah, you learned about two topics, so try to imbibe those two topics in your project. So that would be an updated version. And that isn't not updated version of your project, but an updated version of yourself. So you learn like, this is the project, this is the idea, this was on work, and I learned about it, and I tried to imbibe it, and you definitely grow better with this. So this is one aspect. This is one aspect which is extremely helpful, and for what you say. So for the initial level, for the initial stage. For the beginner stage, most of the people follow the type 1 projects, and it is beneficial, as well as I would promote to follow type 1 projects, even if at this stage or at a further stage, at a later stage, I mean, at any stage, you would be majorly dealing with the experimentation part if you are a core data scientist, right? So that is one thing. Second comes the PyPy project thing. The PyPy is a Python packaging index. Python packaging index. That's an open source collection of all the packages. So what you do is like you build up a package. Like I have three projects on PyPy. Most probably I'll add one more project or two more projects depending upon my the availability of the time. So whatever it is. So basically, you are working on something. Let's say I was working on QuickML. So QuickML received about 50k downloads in a very short span of time. And even though the work is not complete, there's a lot of things I have planned on my bucket list as usual. So there's a lot of things I have planned on my bucket list. But what do you say? Either I'm too lazy or or I don't find the time to get it done. So whatever it is, so yeah, so I was working on computer vision. I've been working on computer vision, and I could observe that there's a lot of things which can be made generic or can be helpful for people. If this is a reusable part of code, you can upload it to the internet, that anybody from anywhere can download that package and you utilize for your own experimentation. So that was it. So if you find something like that, you make a package out of it and you publish it to PyPy. How does that kind of project help? So that kind of project has a wider reach. Definitely, it has a wider reach. It has a public utility. So basically, PiPi projects are utility projects. Those are utility projects. They have a wider reach, and yeah, that's a different kind of, that promotes a different kind of skill development. That promotes your Pythonic skills, your algorithmic skills, and yeah, that's good. That's good. As well as that would promote your machine learning skills. If you are definitely building a data science Python package, it will promote your machine learning skills as well. Coming to the next and last part, that is the app development. So app development is something entirely different, So what we were focusing entirely on in the first part, first kind of projects is like, you're given a data set and you're asked to make predictions, you're asked to make modeling and all the different kind of things, like, yeah, this is what it is, boom, like, and then comes the second part, like, the Pythonic skills comes into play, and they have an importance, right, like, you need to consider your Pythonic skills, make a package. But when it comes to app development is something like, you consider that this, if I make this app, this would be helpful for the community, or that's not even helpful. That's a very absurd direction I'm diverting to. I must not divert. So what is app development? App development is basically your software engineering skills, based majorly software engineering skills, and you combine that with your AI skills. So modeling and prediction, that was all about part one. So when you're done with the part one, you obtain the output. You obtain the model, right? You have obtained a model. You find that this is the model that I need to work with. This is the best possible model I can have. And once you find that, how do you utilize it? That is through app development. However, I would not promote too many projects on app development, because that would be time consuming. However, one or two should suffice extremely well. I mean, that should be extremely impressive if you have utilized your AI skills to make an app and deliver it to the people for the benefit of the people, or hopefully for the benefit of the people. Yeah, and so that's it basically. So majorly you will be concentrating. So just the bottom line, or how would I wrap it up? To wrap up my last 12 minutes, I would say, so first is the major thing. So you will be taking up projects, you will be taking up any data set, you will be doing initial analysis, you will be doing the initial prediction, the modeling, and all the different things. But when it comes to app development, it's like, okay, so don't focus too much on this, because it would be extremely time consuming. So is your Python packaging. Not that much, however, that is on an intermediate level. Yeah. And how does it help? So you're working on something, you find like, how to do basically, now the next part. Next part, which is where equally important, how to do the Python, these kind of projects. So when I started off, I honestly didn't understand like how to make a project. So there are many projects. So let us say I'm working on the animals data set. I pick up an animals data set. How do I do something new? Or how do I add value to it? So read a lot of work which has been done previously on this. One is like, you start banging your head against the data set, against the wall, against something, just keep banging your head, keep pulling your hairs, keep just may frustrate yourself unnecessarily. So something or the other would get out of it, would come out of it. So something, when something comes out of it, that is your initial leveling, that is your initial understanding of whatever is presented to you. But when you start reading other people's work, you start reading other people's notebook, you start reading and understanding what they have done, what they have understand or utilized of this. So that is a different thing, and that does help you try to incorporate those particular the new things which you have learned, like this was somebody else's work, I learned this from here, I learned this was somebody else's work, I learned this from here. You pick those two things, amalgamate those, make your own project. That is also equally good. And a time shall come when you will have a greater understanding of the things that you didn't have. So one is theoretical understanding and knowledge. That definitely is needed. However, the other part is implementation. That is what is needed to show to the people. Like, this is what I have done. However, without theoretical understanding, if you're just copy-pasting this stuff, that wouldn't have, and you'll be caught red-handed. Right? You'll be caught red-handed if in one of the interviews or anything, or even if the workplace. Somehow or the other, you'll be caught. So one day or the other, you need to perform the things, right? So no matter what you do, you need to be genuine with yourself, and there's no point of rushing up. So there's no point of like, there's a lot of time, even if it feels like there's a lot to do. At this stage, like, I've been into data science since 2018, June 2018, I've been into data science, and it still feels like there's a lot to do, there's a lot of things I haven't done, I wish I could have done this way, I wish I could have done that way, and you know, that is absolutely natural, right, isn't it? So if you don't feel like, I have done this, I have done that, and I hope I could have done this way, I hope I could have done that way. If you don't feel that, that is absurd. And if you feel that, that is great. That means yeah, you're going good. Yeah, going good. Keep it up. Yeah. So now comes to the real another aspect. So when I started off 2018 to 2019, what kind of projects did I focus on? What kind of things did I like? This is something I would love to dig in and just complete it up. And these are the works I'll pick up. And like, so I was like, 2018 I started off, 5 to 6 months I did study a lot about data science. I've had a pseudo feeling, like I mentioned in the first video, I had a pseudo feeling like this is all. I learned a lot about data science. I started off with projects. I didn't start off with projects on the GitHub or on Kaggle at the initial stage, at least for the first year. So 5-6 months, those were like all about learning. Then I did a research project. Then I did internships, again a research project, then the college research projects, and reading a lot of the people's work, a lot of people's work, but understanding a little, because I was a beginner, absolutely, no shame in it. I hold no shame in it. I mean, you must admit, like, if you're a beginner, you cannot understand the work of the proficient or the expert people, but it is like, you just keep on reading, at one point of time it feels like, okay, all right, and let's do it. So this is that how the transition happens. This is how the transition happens. So in the first, I started off with the projects at before 2-3 months before my graduation. So I started off my data science in my pre-final year, and I did do projects on the research projects. I did them religiously, meticulously, and with full dedication. I did research projects. I did the projects which are associated with some courses on Coursera or Udemy or whatever it is, whatever you're picking up to learn. So those kind of projects also help you, like, but you do not get to publish them on GitHub or GitLab, whatever the platform you're using, because those are generic projects and those wouldn't be a good benchmark or an indicator for what you understand. So what you understand is something like what you build, right? So those are absolutely good, and those would help you to keep in touch with your other skills, with your other things, like, yeah, other things like how to make a project, how the things happen, those help in your understanding and development. Then comes like the so basically how I did was I spent a lot of time. I didn't rush in my initial phase. However, these days, if you find me, if you want to connect with me, you can connect me on LinkedIn. If you want to connect me directly, you can ring me up. You have my number. It's available on the internet easily. And if you even if you don't have, just hit me up on LinkedIn. I'll share the same. I've helped a lot of people, and this is the reason I'm making these YouTube videos. These YouTube videos are basically compilation of all the telephone calls I receive. So somebody or the else is like, hey brother, can you help me with this? Hey, can you help me with this? How do I do this? How to make a portfolio? How to do this? How to do that? So this is all about how to all the compilation of the different things or the queries I receive, right? Yeah. So in the first year, or this basically when I started off in the third year, I started in the pre-final year. I didn't dedicate much to the GitHub or the Kaggle projects. How I did is quite different, and here I am to share my story. So how I did is ensure that my research projects are at par with the top level guys, right? So I ensured like I am honestly dedicated to my research projects. And I'm not just doing it for the sake of doing it, right? So I dedicated a lot of time and dedication to research projects. I did them rigorously and meticulously. Then also comes the projects which you get from the course projects, as well as the people's projects. So these were things which I did initially, and that helped me understand. Like that helped me a lot. And then just before graduation, I started off publishing my work, and that was at a very rapid stage. That was extremely rapid. So I was like publishing at a frequency of sometimes one project a day, or sometimes two projects per week. I mean, the mathematics might seem weird. So basically two projects per week, but the rate at which it was done, either a day or two. So that is the proficiency I would say you will definitely reach. So I couldn't do at this rate, but now I'm able to do. So definitely you will also reach this project, but don't just rush up the initial stage. Don't rush up. So there's a lot of time, and if you feel perplexed, dilemmatic, frustrated, tempted, overwhelmed, inundated, anything, so depending upon how the things are happening, so just understand that. Okay, just make sure that you are understanding the theory. If not, switch to the implementation. If you don't understand the implementation, switch back to the theory, and that is how it works. So you must have a good combination of the theory and the implementation, and that is how you build your portfolio. How does the portfolio help? Portfolio helps in connecting with different people, as well as showing your work to the recruiters, as well as it helps in the technical rounds. So if people see your work, what you've done, that helps in gauging your understanding, that helps in gauging your perception about the knowledge of the subject or the domain you're working on. Like, yeah, so, and if you are a multidisciplinary guy like me, so I work in data analysis, machine learning, computer vision, NLP. So have few projects from each of them in a good and systematic manner. And keep revisiting your old projects. That does help. So you've been learning what you did 1 year before. 1 year before. If you revisit now, we'll be definitely adding some improvements to it. And that is how it keeps on growing. It's an iterative process, and no need to rush. But so I would say you need to rush, but not always. So that you are the best decider is ultimately up to you. You are the best judge for yourself. So once you understand, like, I'm done with the theory, I'm done with the understanding. So many people don't do the theory. and understanding. So do the theory, complete your understanding, jump to project making, make your portfolio. The better projects you have, the better it is for the technical rounds, for everything, even for your own understanding. Let's keep aside the technical rounds, right? I always believe, like, for if you are to appear for an interview, you should appear as if you are going for a casual conversation. You should not prepare for any interview. And that's it. So your technical projects would speak for you. That's the bottom line. Yeah, I hope that this particular video helped you out. If you want to check my projects, you can find them on Kaggle, on my Kaggle public account. You can find them on the PyPipe account. And yeah, that's it. I have a data science community. It would be great if you join that community. There's a community of like-minded data scientists who come together, discuss from different parts of the world and different time zones, and discuss here and collaborate. There are a lot of things which happen over there. The link would be down in the description. It is anturibjana.wixsite.com/data science. And yeah, if you want anything particular from me, if you would love to know anything in particular, like, please help me with this particular topic. I'll be coming to those things in near future. Presently, I'm concentrating on the part which is not mentioned or shared by everybody. How to get the things happen. So how to make it happen. This is what the video is about. How to make the things happen. Yeah. So that's it. Take care. Bye-bye. And do like, share, subscribe. Yeah, please do.